Good morning students, once again I welcome you to my video lectures on control systems. And in the last class I explained how to locate phasors like S+1, S-1 phasor, etc. Because GS or HS will have factors like this, S+1, S+A in general, S+A or S-A in numerator or in denominator. That is why as a preliminary concept I explained location of S+1 phasor, S-1 phasor on the S plane. Now, I am not going to the theory of root locus. Because you have to become familiar with fundamentals. That is why I have taken a control system. This is what is called as unity. As you know that this is a unity feedback control system. Forward path is having a constant k, which is a real quantity which is varied from 0 to infinity. So k is varied from 0 to infinity. So k over s into s+6. S forward path, and in the feedback path hs equal to 1. Now I am going to sketch the root locus for this, not by real procedure but by factorization. So, by doing factorization on characteristic equation, I will show you the root locus. Then, after understanding the concept of the theory of root locus, yes, without factorization, you can plot the root locus. But before that, I will take an example. So, this is the example. Now, what is the characteristic equation? The characteristic equation is 1 over k over s into s+6 equal to 0. That is 1 plus gshs equal to 0. This is what is called as characteristic equation. Now simplify. If you simplify this, characteristic equation becomes s into s+6 plus k equal to 0. That is s square plus 6s plus k equal to 0. Now the characteristic equation is of degree 2. That means there are going to be two roots, because this characteristic equation is a second degree equation. It is a quadratic equation, and there are two roots. So s square plus 6s plus k equal to 0. Now what about the roots? What about the two roots? The two roots are S1, S2 is equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square, that is 36, minus 4ac, that is 4k, divided by 2a. 2a means, that is minus 3 plus or minus square root of 9 minus k, because when you take it inside the square root, plus or minus 3 plus or minus root of 9 minus k. Now I will give specific values for k. And you are supposed to calculate S1 root and S2 root. First, give values to k. Now, first k is equal to 0. So, this is minus 3 plus root of 9 minus k. Whereas, this root is minus 3 minus root of 9 minus k. Now I will go on giving values to k equal to 0. If I give k equal to 0, then S1 root is located at minus 3 plus or minus 9 plus 3, therefore 0. S1 root is 0. Then what about the S2 root? k equal to 0, then it becomes minus 6. k equal to 6. Next. Next is, I will choose the value of k. I will choose the value of k. Now, minus 3, k. Now, I am giving values to k. First, k equal to 0. If k equal to 0, S1 root will be at 0. K equal to 0 means 3 plus 3 minus 3 plus 3 is 0. Next, k equal to 0 here, minus 6. K equal to 9. If you give k equal to 9, then this is at minus 3, and k equal to 9, this is also at minus 3. Next, k equal to 18. If you take k equal to 18, next to minus 3 plus 9 minus 18, then 18, 3j, minus 3 plus 3j. Next, what about this one? Minus 3j. Next, k equal to 25. If you take k equal to 25, next minus 3 plus 4j. Next, k equal to 25, so this root becomes minus 3 minus 4j. So in this way, if you take k equal to infinity, it becomes minus 3 plus j infinity. Next, minus 3 minus j infinity. Root loci are going to be drawn on graph sheet, two-dimensional graph sheet. Now I will sketch the path of these roots, S1 root as well as S2 root, and that essentially is a root locus diagram. But while after understanding the theory of root locus, you are not going to factorize like this. Only for the sake of understanding, I have taken an illustrative example. First, this is a complex plane. J omega minus j omega. This is origin. First, k equal to 0. S1 is 0. Here. K equal to 0. I will use cross mark because I am sketching the poles of characteristic equation, roots of the characteristic equation. Roots of the characteristic equations are in the denominator. Therefore, use cross sign. Next, k equal to 0. Next, what about S2? S2 is at minus 6 for k equal to 0. Next, k equal to 9. Minus 3. Where is minus 3? So, minus 3 is here, and both the roots are going to lie here. Next, this is for k equal to 9. Next, k equal to 18, minus 3 plus 3j, this is minus 1j, minus 2j, minus 3j, 1j, 2j, 3j. K equal to 18, minus 3 plus 3j, means here, k equal to 18. Next, k equal to 18, minus 3j, here, k equal to 18. Next, k equal to 25, minus 3 plus 4j, so 4j is somewhere here, next, 4j is somewhere here. Minus 4j. And lastly, k equal to infinity, minus 3 plus j infinity. It goes like this. Minus 3 minus j infinity means it possesses. Now join these points. If you join these points, it results in root locus. So locus of S1 is like this. It goes towards infinity. And you have to show the arrow. This is S1 root. Now S2 root is like this. S2 root is like this. S2 root is like this. This is what is called as root locus diagram. For a typical control system in the forward path, K over S into S plus 6 and HS equal to 1. Now this is what is called as plotting of root locus. But after understanding the theory of root locus, we don't factorize and we don't form a table like this. This is for your understanding. So here in the next class, I will take this example again. I will ask you to make some important observations on this diagram, and come to and you have to list the observations. Once you list the observation in this, your next I will proceed further to what is known as theory of root locus. Thank you.